coming up on today's edition of Heart and Soul.
Whether you're a loner, social butterfly, or defined Zen, it's everything. We've got the workouts to match your personality.
And this Howard University grad and female business owner is kicking off a no-holds-barred ad campaign to find a husband. Mm-hmm, we're talking about that one.
Ladies, are you tired of being accused of false advertising for trying to enhance your beauty? Well, now it's the guy's turn to artificially boost and lift. We'll explain what's going on in this video.
Hello there, I am Morgan Miller.
And I am Jackie Herrera.
Yes, you're watching Heart and Soul TV, and we're gonna get right into our Heart and Soul ticker. So we're gonna kick it off with what? Of course, news you need to know. So some Latinos are actually feeling slighted by the Obamacare registration process.
And that's because the Spanish language version of healthcare.gov keeps getting delayed. So even though about 30% of Latinos who lack healthcare coverage and indicate support for the Affordable Care Act, the White House says market research shows 70% of them will apply in English. But the new timeline for the Spanish version has been set for within the next few weeks. I mean, the only thing that really concerns me about this, even though they say about 70% will apply in English, is that the demographic that's gonna be applying for this is probably an older demographic.
Right, the people that need it probably won't be doing that, yeah.
Right, the people that need it won't have access for a couple weeks, and that's just, you know, the point to get it there to them first.
Yeah, we need that ASAP. I can only imagine not being able to speak a language for something that I needed, like right now, and having to wait weeks for it.
Absolutely, and I'm sure, you know, there's people that are actually in hospitals or, you know, they have treatments that they're going through and they need that help, so.
Right, and speaking of health, here's some more health news. Are you having strange dreams, maybe suffering from nagging headaches, feeling tired for no reason? Well, if it sounds like you or someone you may know, it may be your body's way of telling you to chill out, okay? Stress may be affecting your health, even though you're not realizing it. And what causes stress in one person could be totally different from what causes stress in another. So here are some signs doctors say you need to look out for, like eyelid twitching. Unfortunately, this happens to me all the time. This does not mean that someone's talking about you. There's that little myth that goes around, but stress is one of the most common causes of eye spasms. It actually occurs in one eye and lasts a few minutes for several days. You ever?
Can you see mine?
Are you twitching today?
It twitches.
I'll stress you
like
out.
The last week, it's been like twitching away.
I'm sorry.
So here's an
indication. I know what that's like though. So maybe you need to chill out.
I'm going to.
Also, acne. Believe it or not, stress increases inflammation that leads to breakouts. And this is actually more from emotional stress than anything else. So you're not dealing with something, talk it out.
Emotional ASAP. And maybe even hormonal.
Yeah.
You know.
You know what she means. Also, bleeding gums. Chronically elevated levels of the stress hormone cortisol can impair the immune system and allow bacteria to invade your gums.
That's a new one.
Gross, freaky, and makes you pay attention. And hair loss. Super high levels of sex hormones called androgens, which zoom up during stress, could mess up your hair follicles to prompt temporary hair loss. No one wants that.
That is a big no-no.
Yes, yeah, so when you're brushing your hair and you see some strands coming out, it's
stressful in itself just to see those few.
You're like, what?
But if it comes out in, you know, greater masses, that's scary for sure.
Yeah, your body reacts to things that you're dealing with. Your mind is a muscle for your body. So if there's some stuff going on, you really should take care of it because these things could happen. Also, stomach pain. The brain's nervous system is linked to the guts, so mental stress can wreak havoc on your GI tract. Ouch. Yeah, handle that.
And that makes sense, though.
Yeah.
It all really makes sense, because those are things that your body's, like, telling you. They're like signs, like, hey, I'm not okay. Work with me right now.
You know, me and Jackie work hard. Both of us sitting up here with our eyes twitching.
I know. We're just going to be twitching away.
Yeah. Well, a lot of people often head to the kitchen to reduce stress. I know I'm a stress eater.
Absolutely. Me too. I mean, not only is food a good, great stress reducer, but it's an awesome way to flatten your belly and burn some fat.
Yes.
Research shows that certain foods have waist shrinking and health boosting properties. So check out these superfoods the next time you head to the supermarket.
Okay.
Green tea. Now the compounds in green tea, they make it easier for your body to fry that fat up. And the extra burn can help you shed about 3 pounds a year simply from sipping tea.
Yeah, and it's relaxing.
It is.
From the stress story. That's a good relaxer. Green tea always helps some hot tea.
Puts you like in that zen mode. Right?
Yes. Yes, Jackie, we know, zen, yes.
Bulgur, which is a form of wheat, it contains a lot of fiber, which aids in keeping your body's insulin levels low, and researchers speculate that also may shrink fat cells.
Nice.
And then one of my favorites, blueberries, they are loaded with antioxidants to help improve blood flow, and this actually delivers more oxygen to your muscles.
Nice.
And anytime your muscles are working, you're typically burning fat.
Yeah.
So there you got that one. And finally, yogurt. It encourages the growth of good bacteria in your stomach, which crowds out other bugs that can cause bloating. And specifically yogurt, I like Greek yogurt because it contains a lot of protein.
Yeah, it's a lot healthier for you than the regular stuff, even though the regular stuff is good.
And protein, you know, that's another one, burns the fat.
That's all, and you can eat to burn fat. Who doesn't want to do that?
Absolutely.
I'll do it all day.
Bring on those foods because we'll eat them right here. All right, well, now that you're on the road to a flat belly, it's time to stay the course with a workout routine that fits your personality. So experts say people who engage in activities that they enjoy will usually stick with the plan a little longer. So what's your workout personality? Here are some of the categories. One is if you're a loner, there you go. Well, group workouts, they really aren't for everyone. And if you exercise during your alone time, consider hitting the pool for a swim. Pool exercises, such as water aerobics, pool walking, they're really great for workouts for people with diabetes as well.
I just don't like to talk when I work out. Mm-hmm. I just don't.
You
I
like
don't
to stay the course,
to you.
Be on
I'm
the
not
mission.
Trying to smile. Hey, girl, hey, how's your squat going? I don't care. I just want to focus and get it done and get out of there. And especially for us, I mean, we talk all day long, not just here. So if I can get a moment to myself and just handle that, that'd be great.
She works out with her thoughts.
Yeah.
All right, social butterfly. Since you love hanging out and meeting new people, you can sign up for an exercise class, which is awesome because studies have found that support from people sharing the same experiences and struggles, it can enhance your weight loss outcomes. So another one's bored to death. If you don't have the attention span to stay inside, go for a hike. Fresh air, flowers, that environment, you know, the great outdoors, it just might be the best way for you to get active and pass the time.
Yeah.
And if you are Miss Zen, if you enjoy a more structured and relaxing workout, you can try yoga. This practice, it just balances your body, your mind through stretching and breathing techniques. And we talked about anti-gravity yoga yesterday. So
yeah.
That might actually be a really great option you can do.
I like the tantric yoga where it's like 90 degrees in the room and actually more than that. And
it's
you're
like
just
107,
sweating.
Right?
Yeah, it's crazy. But it's
crazy,
it
but awesome.
Yeah, you sweat out all your water weight and it's brilliant. I
it
love that one.
It burns those calories for sure.
Yeah.
All right, well, a businesswoman isn't leaving things up to fate.
Mm-mm.
She's launching a massive ad campaign to find her husband, and we're gonna talk about that.
Lord have mercy. And a Hooters waitress claims she was fired for improper image, and it has nothing to do with the skimpy outfits or highlighting this hairy situation. You're watching Heart and Soul TV.
Welcome back to Heart and Soul TV. We've had the great hair debate several times on this show, and now, unfortunately, a woman is proving that some of the statistics about black hair in the workplace are correct.
Unfortunately, 25-year-old Baltimore Hooters waitress Farron Johnson says she was fired due to improper image after she refused to take the blonde highlights out of her dark brown hair. Take a look.
Other coworkers, they all had different color in their hair, like red and blonde highlights. So I didn't think it would be an issue. He specifically said black women don't have blonde in their hair, so you need to take it out.
Rude. I know plenty of black women with blonde in their hair. Do you not watch reality television?
Seriously. I mean, that's just discrimination at its fullest right there.
Yeah, and she was saying other women have different colors. They have red and blonde in their hair, and they're not forced to change it because of this kind of thing. But I mean, I don't know. I don't want to put anything bad on Hooters, but clearly that boss had something wrong with him for this kind of comment.
Right. He's got to actually take a look at himself. And I'm sure he's not perfect either for, you know, trying to point out something
They're
in this girl.
They're just little blonde highlight. I mean, she didn't come there with a platinum blonde wig looking like Pam Anderson. I mean, I barely noticed it until they zoomed in on it.
It's true. No,
I
it's just
it's
like
cute.
A little strip of it, which
I
is
think
just
it's
ridiculous.
Cute, and it's very on trend, and I think Farron's winning. And you don't want to work at Hooters anyway, so don't worry about it. But, they have yet to comment. She's actually taking legal action against that right now.
Right, so, she filed suit against them. And I hope that she wins because it straight is discrimination.
Yeah.
Well, a hot topic of another kind, trying to change men who admit they can't be monogamous. It plays out on almost every trash TV reality show, and there's this love triangle, like the one that everyone is talking about recently, the Vaughn, Africa, and Alex drama on Bravo's The New Atlanta. Mm-hmm. And then there's Mimi, Stevie J, and Jocelyn on VH1's Love and Hip Hop Atlanta.
My guilty pleasure, yeah.
And in each situation, the guys flat out say they won't commit. But the ladies fight over them anyway. What is going on with that? Women,
I don't know.
Why are you willing to put yourself into that situation?
Who wants to, first of all, who wants to fight over somebody? You're the one that's supposed to be fought for. That's
right.
Not our position to play. I mean, what? No, no. Would you be with the guy that said flat out, you know what?
Absolutely.
I don't want to commit. I kind of just want to kick it with you when I see you, and then when I don't, I'm doing my own thing.
No, absolutely not. And they wrote a book about this. It's called He's Just Not That Into You.
They made a movie, too.
They really did.
Yeah.
And come on now, you know? Why even put yourself into that position? Because you're immediately setting yourself up to get hurt.
I think this is just a common case of insecure women. Unfortunately, it's
yeah.
just how it happens. You feel like, well, I don't think I can get anybody else. And even though this guy said he doesn't want to wait, you know, he's not going to give me his full time, mm-hmm. I'll wait around and hopefully he'll change. And then there's the other woman that's like, well, maybe I can change him from not wanting that woman to wanting me, which is just
no,
is perplexing.
It's ridiculous. But why do we turn on the other woman in the same boat as us instead of the man?
Yeah.
You know, it's like he's the one that's causing all the drama and you're sitting there fighting with the girl when he's the one in the middle. He's,
exactly.
You know,
it's
he's
a
like,
self-worth thing. You are worth it. If he's not willing to just be with you, then he's not for you. It's
right.
fine. There's somebody else out there. There's mm-hmm. plenty of dating sites to find somebody else out there, I promise you.
We've mentioned quite
There's
a few on the show.
There's a whole one dedicated to black women. I mean, good God, just... No.
Move on.
I can't. I'm gonna move on too. If a non-monogamous man isn't for you and you're still having trouble in the love department, you may need to think outside of the box. Mm-hmm. So forget those dating sites and expensive matchmakers I just mentioned. One woman decided to launch a full-on campaign to look for love. Now, Devise Clement is a successful, smart, charming, and attractive former ad agent turned hairstylist who's looking for love, and she plans on using her ad intelligence to help her by launching a love campaign that will feature the following: billboards, a web page, all kinds of social media accounts, and public relations. She'll also have business cards, drink coasters, and yes, TV commercial.
Anything else you'd like to list off? Because that is just insane.
I can't.
It's a lot.
That is,
looking for
I'm
love.
Not really sure how to feel about this one. It's great to see a woman taking initiative and saying, you know what, I'm not gonna sit around, I'm gonna, you know, be proactive about finding somebody for
right.
me. But this just screams desperation, too, at the same
time. And that's exactly what I thought.
Yeah.
Like, the guys that are, you know, maybe that may like her are going to see this and think she's desperate. Because,
yeah.
you know, to run an entire campaign looking for love, I think that the moment she stops looking will be the moment that she
exactly,
finds love.
Exactly, because it's not for us to do. Mm-hmm. Again, ladies, stay in your lane. We're not supposed to be the ones searching. He that findeth a wife finds a good thing. That's a biblical quote. So, yeah.
Well, I'd like to see how it plays out just from the beginning, you know, to see when she launches it and what she actually puts out there and, like, her whole premise and what she says of why she's, you know, even launching this campaign. It just seems like so much work for love.
Yeah.
When it shouldn't be work.
And expensive. She has to get sponsors for this kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's going to cost a lot of money. But what man can honestly be with her and be proud to say that that's his woman when all his friends saw her face plastered all over billboards and ads across it, you know?
This is true. And also, I think that she had mentioned she saw herself on Good Morning America.
Yes, girl, she had a dream that
right?
they were on Good Morning America.
Yes.
And she's like, it's gonna happen too. Well,
she has the vision that this campaign is just gonna launch her and she'll be on Good Morning America, and she knows it will happen because she's got that vision.
Well, you know, God bless her. How about an ad campaign to help pump up men though? That's kind of crazy.
And pump up their pecs, that is. Now, just sit back and take a look at this. everyone's pushing up their chest. That is a new padded undershirt to boost men's pectorals and give them a chance to compete with all the brawny boys. I agree. Okay, so apparently it runs about 48 buckaroos, and women are used to embellishing our beauty, but do you think that this false advertising is just ridiculous on men? Like, seriously. I know. Guys,
we really
like you in your natural state. Like, you guys don't even, you don't wear makeup, you don't have to, you know,
curl your hair. It had arm muscles, Jackie.
I know.
That's not fair.
It's like a mannequin. We're looking at a mannequin.
It's not, you know.
But, you know, just to go on the other side, women, you know, we wear sometimes padded bras, or we wear extensions, or different things that are, you know, not necessarily real.
I'm gonna stand up for the breasts and say this is different because our things, the way they naturally sit,
okay,
sometimes may not be appropriate for what we're wearing at the moment. But for you to just pretend that you have muscles altogether, that's just not fair. How do you, when you, you know, are about to get busy, how does he take that off with confidence? How do you come out of your shirt knowing underneath is a pretend muscle and business on your arm?
You know, I don't even know.
Wouldn't you freak out?
I would definitely freak out. And that guy that was, you know, the one that we have on screen right now, he's got a nice body.
Like, he was fine before.
Yeah, and it's kind of ridiculous that, you know, they put it on. It makes you laugh, actually.
I just don't like a lazy man, and that's what that looks like. You know, I don't have time to, I don't feel like working out, so I'm just gonna put on this top real quick. No. If I can keep it light and keep it tight, then so can he. And if he can't, then he's not for sheep. That's just it.
I know.
I can't.
No, guys, please. Don't do it. All right.
That's nasty.
Okay, so we've got proof that there's still plenty of TLC to go around.
Yeah, the story of the group's triumphs and tragedies has made television history. We're breaking it down next. When Heart and Soul continues, don't go anywhere.
Then you got the funk, hip hop, you know, the low growl.
Can I get an A?
On the road, getting a bite to eat seems to come down to settling for fast food or trying to track down a decent bite in an unfamiliar city. But now Extended Stay America is teaming up with the Food Network's Sunny Anderson to bring the taste of home to travelers across the nation. Thanks for joining us, Sunny. So what are some simple, affordable ideas for away-from-home meals?
Well, first things first, I think it's staying with a hotel that gets it, and Extended Stay America gets it. When you're out of town, if you're with your family, if you're traveling on business, maybe you're working on something on your home and you've got to have a place to stay, staying at a hotel that has a kitchen in every room, a kitchen, you know, a full-size refrigerator, pots, pans, plates, utensils, a stove,
right,
a toaster. I mean, this is how you save money. Why spend service fee, delivery charge, tax, and all of that for room delivery for like a salad? I mean, one time I got a Caesar salad at a hotel, it was like 40 something bucks.
Oh my gosh.
You know? Yeah, it's crazy when you add in all the things, and of course you want to tip someone because it's a service industry and you want to take care of people. But you know, at the end of the day, when you think about a $40 salad versus going out and buying $40 worth of food that can last you an entire week,
yeah,
Extended Stay America is the way to go, and they're everywhere. I just finished my book tour for Sunny's Kitchen. We went everywhere. They have like 44 states that they're across. So like everywhere that we went, I got to stay in an Extended Stay America hotel. I had my kitchen. I went grocery shopping. After I was done, I'm tired. I want to get in the car and drive to a restaurant. I was able to make dinner, and it was really, really cool. I enjoyed it.
Thank you so much. And for more information, check out awayfromhomecooking.com.
Thanks, Jackie. Well, VH1's Made for TV movie Crazy, Sexy, Cool, the TL story, made mega history, and our cover girl, Keke Palmer, actually played the role of Chili. Rapper Lil Mama took on the role of Left Eye, and Drew Sidora played T-Boss. Now, the film became this year's highest-rated cable original film, with nearly 4.5 million viewers watching every magical moment, which made this movie VH1's most watched original film ever. And Twitter was going completely nuts. Take a look at this. Someone said, still in shock, still shaking, still watching. Another tweet says, overall, I give Crazy, Sexy, Cool the TLC story 5 stars. This movie was one great movie I enjoyed from start to finish. Another, see, ladies, TLC is a testament that you don't have to let your daddy issues hold you down. You may prosper. I like that. And the movie was so good, I death teared up a lot. I had no idea that they went through all of that. The acting was so spot on. Did you get to see any of this?
No, I DVR'd it. I haven't watched it yet. Did you get to see it?
I'm just halfway through it, honestly.
Oh, my goodness. But, I mean, looking at those actresses, they look just like them.
Carbon copies.
Kind of eerie.
Yeah.
It gives me the chills a little.
And they did
think
so good.
It.
VH1 really surprised me, honestly, with, you know, all the trash TV that they have that I watch all the time. I didn't think that this would come from that, but it's really good so far.
I love that they also have like all of the pivotal moments though, like just looking at the you know, run.
Yeah.
It's amazing, you know, them at the Grammys, and I don't know, it's just exciting.
I like seeing all the drama that you heard about in headlines, but you never really knew what was going on, like when Chili was sleeping with Dallas Austin.
What?
And she actually had an abortion.
No.
And they show that, but I think it's nice to see that these people are human, that they deal with the same things that we do.
Yeah.
And we all make mistakes, and you know, having a Grammy doesn't change you like that. We all bleed the same color blood, right?
I mean, they're artists, but yes, they're human at the end of the day. And I like that, you know, this movie it allows us to see a different side of them.
Yeah, it's nice to see them kind of humanized and taking all that glitz and glam away. And that fire burning scene was fun tea. She was mad about some shoes, y'all. It was shoes.
Oh, wait, so you said you've been watching
a little bit. I'm halfway. And it's good.
Oh my gosh, I can't wait. I know, I have it DVR'd. I get home a little later.
Like, we want to hear from you guys on social media too. You should check us out. Here's our Facebook page, The Official Heart and Soul. And on Twitter, we're at Heart and Soul Mag TV. That's Heart in Soul Mag TV. Make sure you follow us, like us, all that jazz.
Do it. Hey there, coming on today's edition of Heart and Soul.
So you've hit a rough patch and you need a little something to get you through, but is it healthier to drown your sorrows with sweet or wine? We got the answer.
Well, no sorrows for Rosie Perez. Her latest movie role puts her in the A-list celebrity crowd, but she's telling us exclusively what really makes her heart and soul tick.
And an actress slash comedian is turning her real-life breast cancer story into a comedy act to help others celebrate life. Katie Franco is in studio today discussing her breast years of my life story. Stand-up show, don't miss it.
Welcome to Heart and Soul. I'm Jackie Herrera.
And I'm Morgan Miller.
All right, well, let's get right into that Heart and Soul ticker. Here's news you need to know. Mm-hmm. Racially profiling still exists in the year of 2013.
News you already know, right?
Yep.
And this one is far too familiar. A college student who was accused of fraud while shopping at an upscale boutique, Barney's, has filed a lawsuit against the city and the store. Mm-hmm. Trayon Christian says it happened a few months ago when he went to Barney's to buy a pricey Ferragamo belt seen on the waist of many rap artists. Trayon says after paying for the $349 belt, he was stopped by police accusing him of using a fake credit card. And then he was handcuffed and thrown into a jail cell. And once they figured out his card was authentic, he was released. Clearly,
this is sad.
Issues there. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, I just can't believe that he purchased this item.
Mm-hmm.
He paid with his card that, you know, had his name on
it.
Everything was a legit transaction.
Yeah.
And then they would stop him, cuff him, embarrass him, take him away as though he's a criminal when he's done nothing.
He didn't do anything.
It's horrible.
He actually saved for that. He said his money was deposited that day and he'd been saving. And once it was there in his Chase account, he went there to make sure, you know, he made sure he could afford it. He didn't walk in there empty-handed.
Right. And then apparently the cops asked him how he could afford that belt.
Yeah. How rude is that?
I mean,
they asked him what kind of job he had and those kinds of questions. And they said the reason they followed him was because someone at the store actually alerted him. So
alerted the police?
Yeah, hi, police.
Probably the cashier.
I have his receipt and his sign.
Profiling him?
But I don't know. It's just, it's heartbreaking, I guess, to see that these things are still happening, especially,
right.
I mean, what do we have to do, I guess, is my question. It's just upsetting, especially for a college kid. My God.
Mm-hmm. Well, and then the same thing even happened to Oprah in Sweden.
Yeah.
She was shopping in this little boutique, and she asked, you know, the cashier, she could see the bag that was behind him.
Mm-hmm.
And he said no, and that he didn't want to embarrass her because it was $40,000.
He's like, I don't think you could afford that. Like, boo, do you not know who that is?
Oh,
that is great. She can afford you and this store.
It's crazy. She
and then she
buy
ended up not
store.
Buying it because she was like, you're right, I don't want to pay that much for a bag.
Right.
But he didn't know.
No, I mean, But that's Oprah.
Yeah.
Like, and regardless, if somebody wants to see a bag in your store, that's what you're there for.
Exactly.
You're trying to sell your merchandise. Show
they
it to
almost
them.
Lost a commission.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Well, no, they did. That's for sure. All right. Well, let's get into what's trending for Latinos. A new app to learn English with who? Chespirito!
Chespirito! Who is that?
So he's an icon on Spanish TV, and his show has run for over 30 years.
Oh, wow.
Now, the new app called Learn English with Chavo, it focuses on teaching children English. And I would say that you can compare his show to, like, a Blue's Clues with a comedic take, but for Latinos.
Nice, okay.
And so what we've shown you here, that's the animated version, but there's actually a Blue's Clues kind of segment where, you know, there's people,
with the guy and
there's
that.
Actors.
Okay.
And I remember watching this as a kid.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. So now there's an app for that.
Now there's an app for that. That's like the best term there, right there. And it's funny because Chespirito, I remember growing up, they've got like this like fun, like animated music behind all of the shows. Mm-hmm. And, you know, as soon as I was reading this, I was thinking, man, I remember learning a lot while watching him.
Yeah.
And it's just, I think it's
amazing.
It's
kind of like Dora the Explorer in reverse.
Right.
Right?
Exactly.
Cool.
And just for all of you guys, Chavo means that guy, just so you know.
That, okay, that guy. I like that guy. Well, in health news, if you're sulking in misery and don't want to run for sweets, you should have a drink, okay? Mm. Now, we're not advocating alcoholism, hello, but health experts actually say having a single low-calorie drink like some red wine or maybe a vodka soda with your friends is a much healthier alternative than just reaching for sugar. The experts believe wine calms the nerves and protects the heart without killing your diet. So, for instance, a 5-ounce glass of wine has only 125 calories, but half a cup of that chocolate fudge brownie ice cream that you want has more than twice of that.
Do we have any wine in the house?
Like, you need to relax your eye twitching again.
It is.
Just a little. Yeah, but if you rely on alcohol to unwind, obviously you may have a deeper problem. So you want to avoid booze and have a 150 calorie sweet treat instead. If you feel like you need it,
mm-hmm.
That's not necessarily the way to go.
Right.
But having that drink with healthy meals can actually make you feel fuller too. You know, usually when you drink, you want another one, or
right.
You get hungry and you want to eat more. If you actually have it with a healthy meal, then that one will be fine for you.
It'll be satisfying.
Yeah.
That's good. I like
good
it.
Good for the heart and soul, right?
Yes. All right, well, finding serenity is another way to combat stress. Inner peace is easy on the mind and your wallet, and here are some ideas to get you started.
Okay.
Scented oils. Mm. You can sniff away your stresses
with scented oils.
And because they contain sesame oil, which have fatty acids that are believed to lower stress, blood pressure, and they're shown to help slow the growth of cancer cells.
That's nice.
That is amazing,
yeah.
I think. And find your inner green thumb. Researchers say gardening is an even more effective stress reliever than reading a good book. There's also evidence that microbes in the soil may lift your mood. And then this one's probably my favorite. I'm sure you love this one. Dance, you know, just let your hair down, try something new, go to Zumba classes. You know, because dancing makes you happy and it helps you manage your stress better.
Yeah.
And I know
it's
that.
It's my favorite way to work out too, because you don't realize you're working out.
Absolutely.
It's an all-around good workout.
Yeah, you could definitely do that. Dance a little. I grew up dancing at home. Like
Jackie dances
mama.
And sings all day long. We
so
need to get her a record
so
deal of something. No, I just drop it every now and then.
You do?
Yeah, that's my thing. But you can also find balance in your life by bringing serenity into your home.
Mm-hmm.
So having a home that reflects serenity can bring you some much needed peace. And here are four simple, very simple ways to help you bring that back into your life. First one is declutter. That's
Absolutely.
The big one, you know. We create a more serene atmosphere for ourselves on the outside, but slowly eliminating that clutter, we cultivate a more serene state of existence on the inside, which is really
it's
cool.
It's like cleaning.
Yeah.
Just, you know, cleaning your life.
Clean your house. Yeah. It literally reflects your mind, and I find this happens for me, too. When I'm the most stressed out and I've had, like, a busy day at work, or, you know, I come home and I see all that stuff, it doesn't help me any.
Right, it doesn't motivate you to see all that clutter.
Yeah, you just get more frustrated, you get more stressed out, so declutter.
Mm-hmm.
And simplify your decor, like warm colors and soft, cozy fabrics can actually make you feel more peaceful, make your home feel like a sanctuary. Really cool.
I like that.
Spa baths.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You don't need a big tub to do this. You can create a spa-like environment to your bathroom to bring peace back into your life by just adding some fragrant soaps, some bath salts, fluffy towels, bubbles, and candles. those work.
I love those kinds of baths.
Yeah, it's a great way to come down after a long day.
And with scented oils too.
You sniff your way. Yes.
Take your bath. You're like in heaven right there.
Sniff your stress away and finally allow yourself to enjoy peace and quiet every day, which is really necessary. If you take care of yourself, you'll be better equipped to face the day's challenges. Start with you.
I love that.
Yeah.
You have to start with number one because you have yourself.
When you're together, everything else is together. That's with love and life and in general.
Relationships.
Everything.
Yeah. That's a really great advice. Right?
Jackie likes that.
I know. I love it.
Well, let's face it. Okay. Growing up is really, really hard, right? Especially for kids in schools where most students don't look like us.
Right.
So one group of students put their feelings about it in a video, and we're going to show that to you. That's coming up next.
They put it in a video? I'm excited to see this.
It's going to be really cool.
I think it'll be really
cool.
From a
kid's perspective, yeah.
Absolutely. Well, she is a Puerto Rican actress, comedian, and a breast cancer survivor, and she's spreading the word. Laughter really is the best medicine. And Katie Franco is in the house today to tell us all about the breast years of her life. You're watching Heart and Soul. Welcome back to Heart and Soul. Time for some hot topics.
Yeah, well, growing up in an area where a few people look like you can be really tough, right? So a group of ethnically diverse students at a high school in Minnesota wanted to create a message about what it's like to go to school with mostly Caucasian kids. It's titled, It's All About Respect. Take a look.
We are Lakeville South.
Our differences enrich us.
Our cultures make us who we are.
The melting pot of South.
Maybe more like a mixed salad.
What?
We are better as a society.
Because of our differences.
We come from different places.
Some speak different languages.
And we look different.
Sometimes we use our differences to separate.
To isolate.
To aggravate.
Why do you have to act so black?
Where is your sombrero?
Gingers have no souls.
Are you a terrorist? Do you have a bomb under there?
All Asians are mathematical geniuses and know karate.
We recognize our differences.
But sometimes we want to have a laugh.
That doesn't always focus on our race,
our ethnicity,
or the way we look.
Sometimes there's a pressure to go along with it.
To appear to be cool with it.
To fit in.
It's not to say that we want to ignore our differences.
It's just a matter of respect.
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 We are proud to be who we are.
And we are proud to be Lakeville South.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T, please.
It's a matter of respect.
Did that ever happen to you growing up? You have those experiences, those racial experiences, I guess.
Well, actually, I grew up in a border town of El Paso, and so it was kind of switched for me.
Mm.
We were the majority, about 80% of us were Hispanic, and you know, I didn't really have any white, black, Asians in our school.
Really?
So it wasn't until I went to college that I was then the minority, and then it was like, whoa.
Culture shock, right?
There's another whole world out there.
This is what life is like, yeah.
Yeah, that's kind of how it was for me. So it's kind of funny, you know, watching them talk about that because that's not what I experienced early on in life, which is when you really form your opinions.
Right.
And, you know,
But that explains why you're such a grounded person, too.
Maybe
because
so.
You are. Yeah.
Thank you.
And I mean, for me, I was, I think this school that they showed was 86% white. And that's pretty much how the schools were where I grew
where
up.
You grew
Most
up,
of
yeah.
my life, I was either the only one or one of few that were black in my class.
Did you get some crazy questions?
Well, the term Oreo still sticks with me to this day, because that's what I was called my whole...
No way.
Yeah, you can't speak this way and not be black. You have to be black on the outside and white on the inside, I guess, to speak proper English these days.
And you're like, actually, this is the way I speak.
Right, and so then you have these complexes like, well, I guess I'm not.
Then
black
you start questioning yourself.
Yeah, so then the black kids don't like me because I don't talk just like them. And then the white kids are like, but you don't look like us, but you sound like us, and we're weirded out about that. So then that's how I grew into loving my Latina people and wanted quinceañeras because they were the people that accepted me. So yeah, that was my upbringing. So it's cool to see, you know, I guess students coming together and talking about those issues that I know I've experienced as a young person, and maybe that can help motivate some other people to change their minds
about
what
absolutely.
They say.
The ignorance.
Yeah,
for sure, plays a big role in that. But so Rosie Perez is definitely in the in crowd for this latest flick. She's starring alongside Brad Pitt, Penelope Cruz, and Cameron Diaz in Ridley Scott's movie The Counselor, a twisted story of a lawyer's past illegal dealings coming back to haunt him. So we got a little more zen when we caught up with Rosie. Let's take a look.
do for my heart is to stay open to learning and stay open to not only receiving love, but giving love. It's more important to give and to love, you know, and that's when you get real love back. So I think that's what I do for my heart. For my soul, I keep very conscious of trying to be a better person every single day and to contribute in the world and give back to the world, because the world has given me so much. I'm such a fortunate person.
Yeah.
And I think that that's what I do for my soul. As a community activist, I'm involved with the AIDS community in helping to find a cure, but also specifically with prevention. And I work with the Presidential Council on HIV and AIDS down at the White House, that I'm really proud of.
Wow, that's that amazing.
Work. And I work also with Cielo Latino Commission on AIDS, and I also work for arts education for children in public schools, bringing a different type of learning to okay. them. And that's just some of the stuff that I do.
I love her.
She's had such a long career.
She really has.
Yeah, coming from Spike Lee all the way up to right now, 2013.
To the counselor.
Yeah.
And it comes out, I think it just came out this weekend, I think.
I can't wait to see that. I love her.
I know, she's so good. Well, from one funny gal to another.
Yeah, this comedian is standing up, get it, for a good cause, helping other breast cancer patients through the scary process with comedy.
And I called my mother and I said, Mommy, I shaved my head, I did it. And my mom said to me, ay, mija. I am so happy that you did it and you got it over with. You gotta remember, my mother is 70 years old. She's a grandma, she's a very modern grandma, but she's 70 years old. And she tells me, mija, in solidarity with you, I am going to shave my head too. I said, Mom, if you want to do something for me, don't shave your head, shave your legs.
Katie Franco is a Puerto Rican actress, comedian, and cancer survivor, and her comedy show, The Breast Years of My Life, is on the road, and we're so happy to have her in studio today.
Yay!
Welcome.
Thank you so much for inviting me. How exciting.
Yes, it is. Are you wearing pink lips for Breast Cancer Awareness Month?
What was that?
Is that your pink lipstick for Breast Cancer Awareness Month?
Oh, pink lipstick, and I try to wear a lot of pink. I can't show you the rest of the pink that I'm wearing, but yes.
Hello. They thought I was bad.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I'm almost a 9-year survivor, so... somehow people just keep giving you pink stuff, like everything is pink.
I get
you know,
pink overload.
One thing that I used to do when I was going through my treatments was that I would always put on pink lipstick and dark, you know, bright, you know, mm-hmm. because I think that bright colors really make you happy.
Yeah, and, alive.
Yeah, oh. Even the day that I was diagnosed, I wore, actually, this is a coincidence,
really?
I wore bright yellow, and I think yellow is the color of life.
It's
the
is.
Color of gold.
And you look
abundance.
Good.
Thank
I know.
You. You're and you're gorgeous, you.
You
too.
Thank you.
Thanks, lady.
Here we have the Charlie's Angel.
Bam, bam. So tell us a bit about your show, though, right? It's based on your diagnosis.
Yes, well, what's interesting about the show is that, you know, people think, oh, it's a show about cancer. I don't want to go see that.
Right.
It's sad. It's totally the opposite. Uh-huh. Number one, I don't show any sad parts or any parts where they're dramatic or victim. I don't believe in victimhood mm-hmm. While you're going through cancer. I know when you get the news, it's very shocking. But
right. But
I think that we become patients and then we become survivors and we just fight and we strive for it. You know, we just like just try to do the best of it. And I was a comedian before I was diagnosed with cancer.
So that's what probably helped you cope with it, I guess, when you found out you
so
had that ground.
Yeah. So during my treatments, I would go to the Laugh Factory and I would do stand-up comedy.
Mm-hmm.
And I would make a lot of people laugh. And it's a gift that I have. And so it made me feel so good that then I would go into the treatments and I would feel like I was so
this.
Special.
Yeah.
I was
like, boost,
yes,
right?
Like I had eaten steak and French fries and, you know, the whole deal. And so it really helped me. And so then... during my treatments, I had filmed a movie
mm-hmm.
like 3 months before I was diagnosed. And
mm-hmm.
so they did the premiere in New York City. So the producer calls me and I'm in LA, you know, I'm bald. I'm like really
oh
in the worst moment of my life and really weak and like fragile. And
oh,
he says,
no.
You know, we have the premiere of the movie at Lincoln Center. And I'm going, what? And he says, yes, we know you can't go. I said, can't? When a man tells you can't, that's exactly when you want to do what they tell you not to do.
Oh my God.
So I said, I'm going. And I got a platinum wig and I put on my eyebrows and I took my boyfriend and I went to New York City and I had like 15 minutes of fame. You know, I did the red carpet and everything.
Oh my goodness. 15 minutes is going to get a lot longer.
I know.
Because we're keeping you. You're going to stay here with us. You guys don't go anywhere. You're watching Heart and Soul TV. I can't wait to see more.
Halloween is days away. So how do you make sure you're making the best of it? Sharing his Halloween fun is lifestyle expert Sean McEwen. Thanks for joining us, Sean.
Thank you so much, and happy Halloween to
you. Thank you. Happy Halloween to you.
Thanks, thanks.
So you brought all these goodies.
Yeah, we got some great stuff to get you in the mood for Halloween. First of all, this is from Betty Crocker. It's their fruit roll-ups and fruit gushers. Now, I love these because they're a good source of vitamin C. They're also gluten-free. Okay. And this is really great because they have these snack crafts that you'll see here. First of all, they have the pumpkin patch that you see here. Also,
so
the scary witch hats. And then we have the Frankensteins. Super easy to make. Go to BettyCrocker.com/playwithyourfood for all the information on that.
Play with your food. So I love that you can get creative with
it. So creative and festive. We love it. So good stuff. Okay, this is from Radio Shack. These are great. These are do-it-yourself costumes. They have the instruction sheets there and the necessary products for a variety of costumes. You got these fairy wings that light up.
We also
have these like superhero cuffs that you can make, the magic wand. This is really great. They also have this costume prize contest. Go to blog.radioshack.com for all the information on that. Super cool. Stuff.
Okay,
this is really neat. This is from Ryan's, also Old Country Buffet and Hometown Buffet. And on October 24th and 31st, they're celebrating their Scareversary. It's their Thursday Family Night promotion. So from 5 to 8 p.m., you can go there. And kids, if they're in costume, they can eat for free.
Oh, nice.
Which is super great. They also get copies of the Hotel Transylvania on Blu-ray that you see here. Go to buffet.com or their Facebook page for all the information on that from Old Country and Hometown Buffet.
Very
and
nice.
Last but not least, Mrs. Freshley's, their award-winning line of snack cakes and pastries. Great stuff. They have the Halloween jack-o'-lanterns, also the candy top brownies that you see there. And you can pick that up at grocery stores or go to MrsFreshley's.com for all the info on that.
I love it. You're making my sweet tooth hurt right now.
That's what we're here for.
Thank you so much, Sean. It looks like you have us all covered for Halloween, and we're just so happy to have you here with us.
Thank you so much. Thanks.
Back to you, Morgan.
Thanks, Jackie. I know you're jealous because I'm still here with Miss Katie Franco. And she was just telling me about her book, Camarella.
Tell me
how you came up with this name again. Interesting story.
Well, remember, I was at the premiere of the movie, and the governor of Puerto Rico, who's important for us,
yeah,
you know.
I
want to join too.
So when he saluted me, he took my hand and he saluted me. My boyfriend saw that and he said, oh my God, that's a Cinderella moment. Oh. And so he started calling me Camarella.
I love that.
And so I felt so special. I felt like a princess. I felt like so unique. Mm-hmm. And then my boyfriend, who then became my husband, at least I got a husband.
He put a ring on it.
Yeah, put the ring. We wrote Camarella. It's a bilingual book. It's Spanish and English,
yes,
side by side. And so we use it for prevention and laughter, to give us speaking engagements in prevention and laughter, to help students and young people overcome adversity in general, you know, through laughter and through creativity, so they don't drop out of school.
Right. Absolutely. Laughter is so important.
Yes.
And that's what your show is all about, right?
It's about laughter. And do you know that if you laugh for 15 minutes in a row, you burn 40 calories?
You can burn more than that at her show, I'm sure.
That is amazing.
Where can people go to find out more about your tour?
Well, you can go to katiefranco.com. You can go to kimorella.com. And you can find out where we're going to be touring next with the best years of my life and with my shows. It's very
fun. Thank you. Thanks so much for watching Heart and Soul, guys. We'll see you next time.